children, welcome to chemistry class. Today we are going to discuss very important topic, that is water. So water, what is the formula of water? H2O. It is a compound because the ratio of oxygen, hydrogen and oxygen is 2:1. And we talk about water, so many properties we are knowing also. Water, what we say that water is very good solvent, and major parts of the all living things is water. Human body has 65% is water, and some plants have 95% is water. Some plants have 95% is water. Here, it is a very crucial compound for the. It is a very crucial compound for the survival of all the living things. Without it, life could be impossible on the. And distribution of water all over India is not same as. So far distribution of water all over India, you can see in table 9.2, it is given in also. So what we have discussed here about water, what is very important for us, and it is major part of all the living organism. Human body has 75%, human body has 75% is water. And some plants have 95% water. Yeah. That is the human body. Human body. And is for plants. It plays very crucial role for survival of all the living organisms. Without it, life could be impossible. So now we are moving to physical properties. Physical properties. So in physical properties, we will see in physical properties. So in physical properties, it is what is your name? You know, it is tasteless and colorless. Compound. It is tasteless and colorless compound, and it exists in liquid form. Means it is tasteless colorless liquid. Due to hydrogen bonding between the molecules, it has some special character or some special values. Like that, due to hydrogen bonding, the heat of evaporation, the freezing point, etc., are higher in comparison to other compounds have same molecular weight. So we will see this here. It exists in liquid form, and due to hydrogen bonding between the molecule, it has high freezing point, high boiling point, and high heat of vaporization and high heat of fusion. So due to hydrogen bonding, it has high freezing point, boiling point, freezing point, boiling point, high heat of high heat of vaporization high heat of vaporization heat of vaporization in comparison to S2 and S2 means these are also hydride of these groups, like this, you know, oxygen, sulfur, and like this, they are in same. What is also hydride? What is also hydride? But what things? It has a high freezing point, well melting point, boiling point, and heat, high heat of vaporization in comparison to other hydrides due to hydrogen bonding. It's the values of some points like freezing, boiling, etc. is high due to hydrogen bonding. So you remember, due to hydrogen bonding, it shows some special effect. What that we will discuss. So here we will discuss some more physical properties of water. Here, water has high specific heat, thermal conductivity, surface tension, dipole moment, and dielectric constant. So it play very key role. It play very key role in biosphere. Water, due to these properties, play very key role. What are the properties? Water has high specific heat, thermal conductivity, surface tension, dipole moment, and dielectric constant. So it play very important role or key role in biosphere. Due to these properties, it play very important role in biosphere. Due to high heat of vaporization and heat capacity, it helps to maintain body temperature. Means due to high heat of vaporization and capacity, it helps to moderate body temperature. It is an excellent solvent for transformation of ions and molecules required for plants and animals' metabolism. Means we can say it is very important. For what purpose? It is excellent solvent. Means many things can be dissolved in it. So it is excellent solvent for transformation of ions and molecules required for animals and required for plants and for animals' metabolism. Means who transform ions and molecules for animals' metabolism? That water. And due to hydrogen bonding, it can dissolve the covalent compound such as alcohol and carbohydrates. So what we have discussed here? We discussed that the physical properties. Water has some special characteristics, so it play very crucial role or very key role in biosphere. Due to high heat of vaporization and heat capacity, it helps to moderate body temperature, and it is excellent solvent. You know that it is excellent solvent for transformation of ion and molecules for the plants and for animals' metabolism. Due to hydrogen bonding, it can dissolve the many covalent compounds such as alcohol and carbohydrate. So now we will discuss the structure of water. Next is the structure of water. So here we will discuss the structure of water. So water in a liquid form, water in a gaseous form is bendy structure and with bond angle. Here structure of water. Water in gaseous form has a bending structure. Which is bond angle 104.5 degrees.
104.5 degrees. And OH bond length of OH water length of
95.7 PM. Yeah. So water in gaseous form has bent structure with bond angle 104.5 degrees, with bond length OH bond length of 95.7 PM. So here it is the structure of water in gaseous form. In gaseous form, it is bent in a structure and with bond length of 95.7 PM. You see this structure. So here dipole developed. So water molecule is dipolar. Here water molecule is dipolar. Remember it. Means due to formation of dipole, it is a polar molecule. We can say it is a polar molecule due to development of dipole in this. So here in gaseous phase, water is bent in structure with bond length So what we have seen that in gaseous phase water has bent structure with bond angle 104.5 degrees and OH bond length of 95.7 PM. Here, so we discuss. Next, if you see here, in liquid form, in the liquid phase, water molecule are associated together by hydrogen bond. In liquid phase, they are associated together by hydrogen bond. Here, the crystalline form of water is ice. At atmospheric pressure, water crystallizes in the hexagonal form, and the density of ice is low than water. Therefore, water cubes float on the water. And here in winter season, the ice formed on the surface of the lake provides thermal insulation, which ensures the survival of aquatic life. So what we have seen here, we have seen that water in gaseous form has bent structure, but in liquid form it is surrounded together, or we can say in liquid phase water molecule are associated together and forming hydrogen bonding, and in isolated molecules we talk here. So in isolated molecules, H2O. And here the crystalline form of water is ice. At atmospheric pressure, water crystallizes into hexagonal form. So what we say, atmospheric pressure means crystalline form of water is ice. Crystalline form of water is ice. Atmospheric pressure, water crystallizes into means atmospheric pressure. It crystallizes into hexagonal structure like this. It crystallizes into hexagonal.
and the density of ice is low than the water. That's why ice gives float on the water. And the ice formed on the surface of water provide insulation. Provide insulation or thermal insulation, which ensure the survival of aquatic life. Means in winter time also, you may see that aquatic animals live in water. Aquatic animals live in water. So, what is the reason why they are safe there? The ice Here you may see that in winter season the ice form on the surface. Means in winter season ice form on the surface of water bodies. Surface of water bodies provide thermal insulation. Thermal insulation doesn't allow heat to transfer from here to there like this. It can't provide method or a process to transfer of heat. Outside or inside, which this is thermal insulation, and because of this the aquatic animals can live in water during winter season. So you remember it that due to the formation of ice on the surface of water bodies that provide thermal insulation, ensure the survival of aquatic animals in the water. If ice is not being formed on the surface of water, it could be difficult for the animals, those who are surviving in water. So here we discussed, I would like to discuss in gases form, water is has bend structure, water has bend structure with bond angle of 104.5 degree and OH bond length of 95.7 degree. It is a dipolar molecule, it is polar molecules we can say, because I have shown that dipole is developed, so it is polar molecule. That is a polar molecule. And in the liquid form, liquid form water is associated together by the hydrogen bonding. In liquid form, water is associated together by a hydrogen bonding, and the crystallizing form of water is ice, and atmospheric pressure. Water crystallizes in the form of hexagonal form. Here you remember atmospheric pressure, the ice crystallizes in hexagonal form, and the density of ice is lesser than the water, so water gives float in the water. And due to formation of ice on the surface of water bodies, it provided thermal insulation, and that helps the aquatic animal to live inside the water. Here we will discuss the structure of ice. So for the structure of ice, you may see case number 290 and figure 9.2, the structure of ice. So the structure of ice, if you discuss here, ice has highly ordered three-dimensional hydrogen bonding structure. Water has highly three-ordered hydrogen bonding structure. I showed in figure. Three-dimensional, highly ordered structure. By X-ray analysis, it has been seen that each oxygen atom is surrounded tetrahedrally by four other oxygen atoms. Means each oxygen atom by X-ray examination says that oxygen each oxygen atom is surrounded, is surrounded tetrahedrally, tetrahedrally by oxygen. Atom at a distance, oxygen. Atom at a distance, of 276 pm. So here, this is the structure of ice. For the structure of ice, you can see the base 290 diagram figure 2.9. So ice has three dimensional highly ordered structure. By X-ray examination says that each oxygen atom is surrounded tetrahedrally by four oxygen atom at a distance of 276 pm. Now we are going to next is, so our next is chemical properties of water. So here we are going to discuss chemical properties of water. So chemical properties of water means water reacts a large number of substances to give different product, but some important reactions are given available. So first reaction is of this amphoteric nature. First is amphoteric nature. So what does mean of amphoteric nature? Amphoteric nature is that sometimes water acts as acid as well as bases. A substance which acts as acid as well as base is called amphoteric. Like this, if you take example of this one, so here H2O, when it reacts with NH3, here NH4 plus and OH minus. So here act as AC. When it reacts with H2O, react with H2S, it acts as base. Here acts as base. A substance which act as acid as well as a base is called amphoteric in nature. So water has this property. It acts as acid as well as a base in its amphoteric substances. In the pronounced sense, it acts as acid. So what we have discussed, amphoteric nature means, amphoteric means, if simple some simple way we say that a substance which acts as acid as well as base is called amphoteric. So H2O here, you may see H2O there acting as acid and here as a base. So according Bronsted theory concept, it is amphoteric in nature. It is amphoteric in nature. A substance which water act as acid as well as in base. According to this concept, according to the Bronsted theory concept, we say that it is amphoteric in nature. So here H2O acts as acid as well as
Okay, yes.
So it is toric amphoteric nature. When it reacts with NH3, when it reacts with NH3, it acts as acid. That product we get. And when it reacts with H2S, it acts as base, and that product we get. So by this reaction, we can show that it acts as amphoteric substance. And hydrolysis of this also. ABC hydrolysis of this also, it is better to show reversible reaction. It is better to show reversible reaction. And hydrolysis of this can be written like this: H2O plus H2O. It forms H3O plus and OH minus. Here, so we can write acid, and so if I write here base conjugate, here this base and acid conjugate. So one thing you remember, it conjugate has difference only proton. How it is? You see here conjugate, if you see here in this acid base conjugate, acid base conjugate, you see both has difference of H plus. If you will add H plus there also, that will change into H2. First thing I wrote here. So acid base conjugates has difference of proton, we can say, or H plus. So on this basis we can say it is amphoteric in nature. So here redox reaction involving water. Okay, redox reaction involving water. Water on reaction with highly electropositive metals get reduced to H2. Here 2H2O plus 2Na gives out 2Na, OH plus H2, and water is oxidized to O2 during photosynthesis. So by these reactions we can say that redox reaction involving water, means redox reaction involving water. So on this basis we can say that redox reaction involving water. Our next reaction is hydrolysis reaction. Next is hydrolysis reaction. What is hydrolysis reaction? Due to high dielectric constant, it has tendency to dissolve many ionic compound such as certain covalent ionic compounds, certain covalent and some covalent and some other compounds also. Some other compounds. So first we will write what is, we can write P4S10+S2O. It forms S3PO4+ this much only will be right. Okay. And next will be right SiCl4+H2O gives out SiO2+4HCl. 4HCl. And next is Bn3+3H2O gives what? Gives NH3+3OH-. Here I didn't balance, so you can balance it. Here you can balance it. Here 4 and 6H2O. Okay. And here also we balance it. 2H2O, 4HCl and SiO. So here hydrolysis breaks. Due to high dielectric constraint, it has tendency to dissolve many ionic compounds, certain covalents and some other compounds here. You may see P4S10+6H2 gives out 4S3PO4. SiCl4+2H2O gives out SiO2+4HCl. SiN3+3H2O gives NH3 and OH. So this reaction, hydrolysis reaction, is possible due to high dielectric constant. So these are the properties of chemical properties of water. So how many properties we discussed? Very few properties we discussed. What properties we discuss one time, we can revise. So first, amphoteric property of H2O. You say, you see that H2O act as acid as well as base. So it is amphoteric. For example, when H2O reacts with NH3, it acts as acid. When it reacts with H2O, it acts as base. So it is amphoteric in nature. And next, we have seen that. Next is amphoteric and redox reaction. Redox reaction involved in water. So redox reaction, we have seen in redox reaction is one diamond is getting reduced and other diamond is getting oxidized. And last reaction of this one is hydrolysis reaction. Due to high dielectric constraint, it has tendency to dissolve many ionic compounds, covalent and certain covalent compound and some other compounds. So it can dissolve. So these are the chemical properties of the what?